Hi there, Yogi Virendra Yogi. This is our prime responsibility of every enlightened citizen of this world to be very useful and very productive so that we can really leave a monument on this planet Earth, as did Shah Jahan by making Taj Mahal in the memory of his wife Mumtaz Mahal. The definite purpose is very essential to be successful in life, the destination where we are going is our personal initiative, and the basic needs is food, shelter, clothes. That is very essential for everyone for survival, and then there can be different goals, different destinations, different milestones we are going to set for ourselves. But all is dedicated and committed in the service of mankind. No greed, no selfishness, because the wisest people become immortal in their deeds. Buddha did it, Jesus did it, so many great people did it. Abraham Lincoln did it, they did it. George Washington did it. Millions of such great brave hearts made a monument of their lives, but we still remember them and their contribution reverberate in our conscience. We stand out of reverence in their great deeds and action, but we have not to be just a poet to praise their glory and greatness. We have to be inspired by them, and we have to become one of such great people on earth. So there should be the greatest definite purpose of our life. Lives of great men all remind us we can make our life sublime, and departing leave behind us footprints on the sands of time. Let us then be up and doing, with our heart on a definite goal, still striving, seeking, finding different means and means, and learn to labor how to really become so important person for the mankind. We don't want anything for ourselves. But if you are born on this planet Earth, this life has to be validated. It has to be converted into immortality. It's possible. So start dreaming, desiring. Cherish your noble vision, cherish your noble ideals. If you look in the history of the modern time, the Google, Microsoft, WhatsApp, YouTube, Amazon, Alibaba, SpaceX, Tesla Electric Motors, they are all dreamers, started their business in garages, in ordinary places. They were having nothing, but they have personal initiative, determination, commitment, willpower. The consuming obsession of their life was backed by a burning desire, setting a very definite purpose in their life, and we cannot forget that. My role model, Steve Jobs, wanted to make a dent in the world, and he did it. Bill Gates wanted to give mankind the best possible means of digital electronic systems, and he succeeded. Elon Musk, one my hero, he wanted to make us have a trip to the space. He's a space exploration, Falcon Heavy, so and so forth. This great man wanted to see the Earth free from all pollution, discarding all these automobile propelled by gasoline, lot of pollutions, lot of toxic gases. He has transformed the world, inspired the millions motor industries to go for electric vehicles. What you are doing, what I am doing, what you are doing, life is short. We all will die one day. We died like a dog. Foolish. or we die like great heroes, Abraham Lincoln. We die like any great man who has a mission and purpose and vision. Yes, the latter is preferable. Think seriously. Don't just live aimlessly, powerless, useless, foolishly, wasting time in eating, sleeping, quarreling, fighting, criticizing. Rather, studying, thinking, innovating, discovering different ways and means, rendering great service to the mankind so that the humanity will not forget us. But there has not to be a greed. There has to be a passionate love for the mankind. Buddha gave us the enlightened way of living life of stainless beauty, tranquility, peace, serenity, steadfastness, and everything what can make us live very happily. He has no greed. He loves mankind. He pity on the suffering masses with lot of compassion. So don't think that once I'm telling that be immortal means be greedy or selfish. No negative mental attitude. No greed, no selfishness, no hatred, no jealousy, no cynicism. Only love, compassion, kindness. And out of that, as we do for our children, the whole universe is our children. The birds, beasts, animals, plants. Love for everyone. Affection for everyone. Kindness for everyone. That's the meaning of immortality. Dear friends, that's the whole goal of our life. Opportunity is very less. There is a tide in the affairs of man. If taken at flood, leads on to fortune. Omitted, all the voids of their life, they are found in misery, sorrow, grief and pain. On such